Jack's master, the carpenter Owen Wood, overhears this remark and comes to cuff the boy.
The devil you have! What, and rob the mail like Jack Hall, I suppose, eh, you dog?
Yes, I will, if you beat me in that way.
Oh, Jack, Jack, mark my words, you'll come to be hanged. Where did you learn that song I heard just now?
At the Black Lion in our street.
Oh, the worst house in the neighbourhood. Who taught it you?
One Blueskin. It was that song put it into my head to cut my name on the beam.
Pretty company for an apprentice to keep. That Blueskin was tried at the last Old Bailey sessions and only escaped by impeaching his accomplices. Jonathan Wilde brought him off. Now, Jack, mark my words. You're a very idle lad, and idleness is the key of beggary. If you don't avoid taverns and bad company, I must give you up your indentures, and you must seek another master.
I will be a good boy, sir. Indeed, I will.
Now, set to work and finish the packing case, and take it immediately to Lady Trafford's.
Yes, master, like a shot. Of all that number, there's came not one who carved his name on the Newgate stone with his chisel so fine, tra-la-la-la, with his chisel so fine, tra-la.
While Jack is out delivering the case, Thames Darrell, Wood's other apprentice, whom the carpenter treats like a son, meets Winnie, Wood's daughter, in the workshop. Thames is so named because 12 years earlier, when he was still a baby, he was rescued from the River Thames by Wood on the night of the great storm of 1703. Thames now reveals that he is planning to leave Wood's establishment to become independent. This is heartbreaking news to Winnie, who adores Thames with all the pure passion of a first love. She falls weeping on his shoulder, and Thames tenderly embraces her. At just this moment, Jack returns. He is far from pleased with what he sees, for he is in love with Winnie.
Aha! I've caught you, have I?